you think you've seen it all on The X Factor, then how wrong you were. We've got even more unnecessary sped-up shots of the judges. Even more swooping shots of crowds. And we're just packed to the rafters with hilarity.
Brilliant!
I'm just going to clean my teeth.
Get up, everyone! And this is The Extra Factor. Factor, and we're here in... Where are we?
Behind you.
Oh, we're in Birmingham. Yes, we're in Birmingham, that place where people live. And they've gathered in large crowds, made up of people you're unlikely ever to see again. Like him. And her. And oh, hello you! They're all a little overexcited because they're in the home of the curry! Okay, calm down. We've all had one. Right, that's better.
It's the home of the Bolte, officially, here in Birmingham. I wanted to know, what's your favourite curry? Do you like curry?
I love curry, yeah.
Yeah, do you like curry, actually?
I'm more about the sides in curry than I am the actual curry itself.
I go to the ones with, like, the three chilies at the side.
And then I'll get a sagaloo.
Do you like curry?
Yeah. And aloo gobi.
I have been on top of Tenderloin, yeah.
Have you asked Simon this question?
Do you like curry?
Yeah, not this time of day.
Yes.
What do you go for?
It can't ignore me.
This sort of... Yeah, love curry.
Yes.
Right, now back to more money. Where's the money kept around here? You don't want to keep asking Simon the same question, so you always try to put these different questions when he comes in. And invariably, they're the ones he always ignores.
I know. But I'm just going to keep asking him until he answers.
Yeah.
Do you like curry?
Do I like curry? Why are you asking me that?
Well, are you going to try the hottest curry in the world ever? Because that for me would be a great ITV2 item.
Would it? What's your favourite curry? Like a vindaloo?
Yeah. Why?
You know, what about if we had, like, a vindaloo roulette? But we had, like, different things of curry.
Actually, you should do that.
Lives on the line, and we're talking about chicken dinner something.
Okay. Well, look, I'm going to leave you now, and I'm going to think about what I've said.
Okay, I would.
In a dark room.
Really looking forward to this morning.
Yeah.
And whilst I go and rustle up a vindaloo roulette for us to play with later, it's time to meet our first auditionees. And there's definitely something familiar about one of these wannabe rock and roll stars. I wonder all which famous celebrity they resemble. He's definitely maybe someone from a famous family. Some might say it's really obvious. Yes, it's Britt Terry! Likeness is uncanny.
Hi, I'm Michael.
And I'm James,
and together we are
the Michael and James.
That's your name?
Yep.
Says
we're proud of it.
Does on the tip. What do you sound like?
We rap, as you may have.
You rap. And have you performed much?
We signed up for a competition at our school.
Oh, right.
We got to the final in that. It was just the X Factor at our college sort of thing.
Oh, okay, so you've already done this once before, but just not the real thing?
No, not on such a large scale, no.
Have you written anything special for today?
It's called the X Factor rap. We penned it on the day of the audition for our competition at school, and it went
took
off.
Took us to the final, yeah.
So let's hope this can take you all the way to the final too, right?
Definitely.
Good luck.
Thank you very much.
Hello, guys. Who have we got here?
I'm Michael.
And I'm James.
And what's the group called?
The Michael and James.
What are you going to sing?
It took a while to make.
What are you going to sing?
We're going to sing a number that we made
off you go.
A while ago. Okay.
3, 2, 1.
Give me an X to the actor.
Thank you. See you later. Off you go.
Thank you.
in case you blinked, and the probability of that is high, here's all 2.1 seconds of that audition again. And here, for all you Michael and James fans, you know who you are. It's the uninterrupted Extra Factor exclusive.
Give me an X to the F to the A to the C to the T to the O to the R. What you got, Mike?
X Factor.
X Factor. Singing is our game, but most are really late. Freestyling, it's our aim.
Can I just say something? Yeah. I think it would be much better if it was X to the T to the R to the A to the F to the A to the C to the T to the O to the R. Yeah. Extra Factor. Can you fit that in?
It's feasible, but I don't know if we'd be able to.
What? Are you about to let me down?
Let's go for it. It's not going to work. Let's go for it.
We can do it.
Give me an X to the T to the R to the A to the F to the A to the C to the T to the O to the R.
What you got, Mike?
Extra Factor!
Yes! That is so much better. Well done. So we're here in Birmingham, which, as we know, is the home of the Balti.
Right.
So we're going to play curry roulette. Under this plate, we have got four curries. No, one of them is very, very hot. It's up to you. It's like an extra hot vindaloo.
Right.
So, there's the curries. Danny, you get to pick first. Fork.
I think I'm very lucky because there's meat in here and I don't eat meat.
So. Are you a veggie?
Oh, I give me two, Danny.
Oh my God, does that mean I'm gonna have to play?
Who wants to go first? I'm gonna open
me.
It up.
Louis.
Yeah. Okay, don't eat it yet. You just have to put it on your fork.
I'm gonna try this one.
Okay, Dermot.
To the left, to the left.
Everybody take a little curry to the left.
It's late lamb, so I'm gonna go right about.
Oh my God, that means I get the brown ones. Okay, one, cheers. Two,
cheers,
three, curry
everyone.
Off.
Holy
You are going red.
Yeah.
All the best for this afternoon.
We'll have some toilet roll by the monitors for Dermot.
Hate you, Archie.
That's how we do this.
The Extra Factor team are still in a place where people live. Look at them, they're everywhere. And whilst these people have gathered to be scrutinised by our judges, backstage, it seems the judges are more interested in talking about each other.
You sit next to Danny.
Yeah.
Does she have any bad habits? Because you're sat next to her all day long.
I like her an awful lot more. We're getting to know her. We're actually having more fun this year.
So do you have like chit chat?
Yeah, we talk all the time.
You sit next to Louis. Does he have any bad habits?
He's pretty quiet.
Is he?
He's pretty quiet and calm.
We talk about everything.
What's it like sitting next to Simon? Has he got any bad habits?
He's got a lot of bad habits, actually.
Such as?
As he sometimes peels tangerines while people are auditioning.
I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly.
He takes my mints.
My mints?
She said they're her mints.
Cheryl, am I stealing your mints?
Oh, no, don't
say
that.
My mints?
They're
mine. You don't want to show your mints.
They're mine. Yeah. I can get you lots of mints.
No, that's fine. No, it's fine. I won't share.
Do you need your own packet of mints?
No, it doesn't matter.
Are you sure?
No, I'll have one for the day, okay?
Cheryl, can you not share?
No, don't. I'll share for
Cheryl. Is this a problem?
It's a sensitive subject.
Move calm.
I've got a mint, Simon. She's giving mints out.
Scuffed high street shoes, £14.99. Non-designer jeans, £29.99. An overpriced latte, £2.49. A boy band auditioning for the X Factor, priceless. priceless. Hello.
Hello.
How are you, boys? You all right?
Yeah, right, yeah.
How long have you been together as a band?
About 6 months, roughly.
We've known each other for about 2-3 years, haven't we?
Yeah, yeah.
So this is your moment.
Yeah.
You're going to get together, form a band, and be the next big boy band, right?
Hopefully, yeah.
Bigger than Backstreet Boys.
Is that what you think?
Oh, yeah.
So if you were to rate yourselves out of 10, what would you rate yourself?
Well, about 10.
10 out of 10?
Oh, yeah, why not?
11 out of 10. Oh. Okay. Do you guys dance?
I can do the worm.
Can you do the worm?
I can do it.
The worm is my favourite.
Yeah, it's brilliant.
All-time dance move. Go on. Here he goes. Oh, my God. That was the most physical worm I've ever seen in my life. You were literally leaping in the floor. What are you singing today?
Backstreet
Boys. I wanted that vinyl.
Right. Good luck. Cheers. I hope it all goes very well. And I'll catch up with you boys later.
Cheers.
Go and be priceless.
Hello. Right, who are you?
Priceless.
Priceless. Okay, how old are you?
I'm 18.
I'm 20.
I'm 18. 19.
Presumably you want to be a huge group, yeah?
Yep.
Okay. As successful as who?
Backstreet Boys.
Okay. Good. So are you doing it for money, girls, fame?
All of it.
Yeah. What are you going to sing, guys?
I Want It That Way by Backstreet Boys.
Okay. Good luck.
You are my fire, the one desire believe when I say that I want it that way. But we might end nothing but a heartache. Tell me why end nothing but a mistake. Tell me why.
Have the charisma of four bananas on that stage. I'm being serious. Anything you want to say back?
Thank you.
No? Should we just leave it at that?
Yeah.
All right, see you later. I mean, 3 years ago, Cheryl, you'd have been in the front row screaming at that.
I'm going to go see the guys and make sure they're all right. In there.
Nerves and just refrozen.
You're complete nerves.
Seeing them fall, seeing the crowd fall.
Simon said you were like four bananas.
You just have to laugh about it. Just laugh it off, don't you?
I like bananas. Do you?
Oh, yeah.
Nice and sweet.
So is this it? Are you going to come back next year?
Yeah. I don't think about 100%.
It. We'll make a comeback, a dramatic comeback.
Sure, Simon up next year.
Well, look, guys, it was so nice to meet you.
Before we go, any chance for a quick photo?
Oh, yeah, sure. Hang on. Okay, ready? Say bananas.
Yeah.
Okay, let's just get the results. Dermot scored 8. I scored 6.
Yay!
The Dominator might have won that one, but next week I'll be back and ready to destroy him in another gripping round of...
Presenters.
Whilst the auditions take a break and the audience scamper for the loos, I went to visit the loo-ee.
From what you've seen, what is a big audition no-no? When somebody walks in doing something, you just go, oh, I've switched off. What's the worst thing they can do?
I like them to be just normal and have a talent. I like them just to walk in and be themselves. I think that's the best thing. I don't like if they're really overconfident and then to sing out of tune. That's really, really bad.
Right. Okay, good luck.
Good luck, Holly.
And I'll catch up with you in a bit.
You definitely will.
All right.
Bye-bye.
On you go.
So, you don't like overconfidence, Louis? Ah, it's a shame no one told our next guy.
It's your boy, Jenny. One man, one mic, one voice.
How we do this.
I personally think I've got the potential to win, yeah, definitely. I am what England is looking for right now. I'm what England needs right now. I think there isn't a Jedi. I think the search is what we should be looking for, is a Jedi. I want to be one of the greatest there ever was. I'm not a celebrity yet in Birmingham, but I'm not far off. People know about me.
Jedi?
Who?
Eh? I've never heard of him, have you?
No.
If you ask about me, certain majority of Birmingham people know about me.
Popeye.
Popeye. I've heard of ribeye, but not Jedi.
I'm Jedi. There ain't a Jedi in England.
My dog's name is Jedi.
When I heard that I was coming to Birmingham, you were one of the main attractions in Birmingham's guide of people to meet. Who's who? So you... Ozzy Osbourne. Jasper Carrot.
Yeah.
Curry. My favourite is you.
Oh, Jenny.
You know what? Thank you very much. Thank you.
And I like curry.
I couldn't tell you why I was so why I was one of the people that I don't, in the book. I don't know. So don't know why that is.
But I hear you're pretty popular around here.
Who? Beardy? I've never heard of him.
Are you sure this guy lives in Birmingham?
Okay.
Hello.
Okay, what's your name?
My name's Jenny.
And how old are you, Jenny?
I'm 23.
What's the ultimate goal here?
I want to be a household name.
What are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing Hello by Lionel Richie.
Okay.
I've been alone with you inside my mind. And in my dreams I've kissed your lips 1,000 times. I sometimes see you pass outside my door. Hello, is it me you're looking for? I can see it in your eyes.
I thought there was a few obvious, I think you know there was a few falters in the song. The performance makes me nervous. I know everyone's nervous when they get on stage. It's something that you're making us feel nervous when you're performing.
Yeah, it means a real lot to me. It means a real lot to me, and that's what it is.
Jenna, it was just an okay audition. You're like a very good karaoke singer.
You talk to your opinion, that's fine for me.
You want my honest opinion?
Yeah.
I don't believe that you are good enough, particularly from what I've heard over the past few days, stand out in the crowd.
Danny, it's a no. Louis?
Jenna, I didn't think you were really bad, but I didn't think you were good either.
You just want a yes or a no.
I'm going to say yes.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Jenna, I'm going to say no. Sorry.
If it's any consolation, I would have said yes.
All right, thank you very much.
Got pulling teeth.
You all right?
I'm blessed, happy.
You good?
Yeah.
You looked slightly stressed when you walked over just then.
I don't. It's nothing to me. I'm happy. Look.
Oh, Jenny. Yeah, I know him.
He's the guy from Birmingham.
Always wears the shades.
Big grin like that.
Yeah, he can't sing.
He can't sing.
He can't sing.
So, as Jenai is shown the door, meanwhile, in the pod, others can't find it. The door, that is.
I can't get out the pod.
How do we get out of here? Where's the door? I want to break free. Hello?
Can anybody hear me? Hello?
Come on, can you help me out? I need a wink.
Come on, I want to get off. The door.
God, no, I'll give up. Just shoot, mate.
Viewers, I have some very disturbing news for you. We're about to come to the end of another part, but hang on in there because we've got a whole lot more coming up after the break. There we are!
We should have a squirter.
Pajamas!
It's a new day on the Extra Factor Tour, and we've hit Vegas! Shut up and put your money where your mouth is. That's what you get for waking up in Vegas. Alas, no one's actually in Vegas to audition, so we've also travelled to, Manchester. And it's time to wake up a certain judge. Which one is it? Can you guess? Louis, you haven't made your bed.
I never make my bed.
Do you make your bed at home?
No. I don't make my bed. Why should I?
You little
I'm the only person getting into it. Well, you know, at night.
Are they your pyjamas?
Yeah!
I wear pyjamas. Can I see your pyjamas?
If you show me yours. If you show me yours, I'll show you mine.
But they're like proper little pyjamas.
They are, yeah. I always wear pyjamas.
Can you just hold them up so we can see? Oh, you're just...
They're my pyjamas, Holly. Yes, I wear pyjamas.
What shirt are you going to wear today?
I've got three blue shirts.
You always have three blue shirts.
Yeah.
You do look good in blue.
Do I?
Go, go, go.
You can't go wrong with the blue shirt.
Can we have a look in your bathroom?
In you go. I have all the shaving cream. Normal things.
Do you have to shave every day?
Yeah, do you?
You're so rude. But touche, I like your style.
We must not forget we're on talent search.
Yes, Louis, good point, well made. We mustn't forget that we are on a talent search. Although, I'm struggling to forget that Louis Walsh, in bed, wears pyjamas.
Yes, I wear pyjamas.
And it's important to remember that there are acts here to audition. Like Big Divas.
I'm Vicky.
I'm Lorraine.
And we are Big Divas.
And we mustn't allow ourselves to get distracted by thoughts of Louis Walsh in bed wearing pyjamas.
Yes, I wear pyjamas.
As these girls have a dream.
Our dream is to perform in, you know, to big audiences.
So the thing about being a diva is that you've got to have the big personality.
Yes.
And a certain attitude, haven't
yes.
you?
Oh, yeah.
Do you ladies have this?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, well, we thought we could put this to the test right now.
Come in, Chris.
Is that espresso macchiato?
Oh, no.
Don't want this.
No, when I ask for something, I need it now, and I don't want that rubbish.
It's not to be the best. Decaf as well.
I second that.
Stupid boy.
That's brilliant! That was absolutely brilliant!
Did you
hear
that?
You are 100%
diva lecture, you two. Hello, girls. How old are you both?
I'm 47.
And I'm 19, going on 61.
Which group in the charts would you compare yourself to?
Maybe Aretha Franklin and Annie Lennox.
Annie Lennox?
Maybe.
Annie's definitely inspired
you. Oh,
you
can
yeah.
see it, can you?
Yeah. No, definitely, yeah. What are you going to sing?
Reet Petit.
Okay.
Well, look about, look about, look about, look about, ooh, wee. Look about, look about, look about, ooh.
Sweet, the finest guy you ever wanna be.
I was so surprised. I didn't think you were going to be that good. I loved your energy. I love the energy. I love the song choice. And you can really sing.
Thank you. Girls, I thought that was so entertaining. And you got them going. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Well, look, it kind of came over as if the two of you were coming out of retirement.
So it's Annie Lennox and her mate in 20 years' time doing a bit of a reunion.
Simon, it's more like Mel B and Baby Spice in 20 years' time.
Five years' time. So, look, I'm kind of torn here because, yes, you can sing. Do I think you can sell records? No. Any yes or no?
Yes.
Cheryl?
Yes.
Girls, for all the right reasons, I'm going to say no.
I really like your voices. And I really like your personality, but you're not going to win the show.
Yes or no?
Okay, I've made my decision. It's yes.
Yeah.
Love that Spice
Girl.
That was good.
That
Louis, you were funny.
You certainly know how to rock an audience,
oh,
don't you, girls?
Oh, we try.
Louis was talking about you girls looking like the Spice Girls.
Scary and Baby.
Scary and Baby in 5 years' time.
Five years. Is that all?
I wonder what that would look like.
I wonder.
I tell you what I want, what I really want. So tell me what you want, what you really want. I want. Ladies, don't you go changing a single thing.
We will.
And I will see you both at boot camp.
Oh,
thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
So the big divas are through to boot camp, but that's not important right now. What is important is that Louis Walsh, in bed, wears pyjamas.
Yes, I wear pyjamas.
And I need to tell some people.
This morning, I was lucky enough to go into Louis's room and found his pyjamas. Bless little Louis, he wears pyjamas every night, which obviously
leaves me. Surprise me.
No, but it kind of surprised me, I have to say.
Are they stripy ones?
Stripy. Yeah. They're like really traditional. So,
got it.
What do you ladies wear in bed?
Stripy pyjamas.
Danny?
Stripy pyjamas.
Anyway, we're getting distracted again. All we seem to be able to think about is Louis Walsh in bed wearing pyjamas.
Yes, I wear pyjamas.
And our next group, Checkout.
We are Checkout.
Claire to Jean. Good luck, guys.
They have absolutely nothing to do with that, do they?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Now, you are called Checkout.
Yeah. We are indeed,
right?
Yes.
We work in Asda.
Yes.
On the tills.
Yes.
So, perfect sense. Checkout was born.
So, what effect will you have on the X Factor this year?
We would make a lot of people rearrange the Saturday evenings. They'll think, no, we won't go out that time. We'll watch the X Factor because Checkout are on it. And ratings for X Factor would soar.
Well, look, good luck.
Plus as well,
we have a surprise for Mrs. Corn.
Oh, yes.
We found out that it was her birthday. So, brains working overtime.
Yeah.
Came up with a cunning plan.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. What could this cunning plan be? Their brains have been working overtime, pens and papers at the ready, viewers, for the birthday idea of the century.
Don't. I'm too excited. Tell me.
Oh, go on, then.
We have bought her a birthday card.
Genius! A birthday card on her birthday! Wow!
It sings Barry White, first,
you're
the
first,
my everything.
Does she like that song then?
We hope so.
We hope so indeed.
Okay.
And then we put in a little message out.
Oh, we put Cheryl, my darling, you indeed put the X Factor into X Factor.
Look at that. You guys are like Shakespeare, man.
Good afternoon and welcome to the X Factor auditions.
What's your name?
checkout.
Any reason?
Hence the name badges. We work on the tills at Asda.
How old are you both?
I'm 42.
19, but 20 tomorrow. My last day of being a teenager.
What was the point where you suddenly went, you know what, we should be in a pop group?
We sing on the tills to the customers all the time, so we thought, well, why the hell not?
And they like that?
A lot of them do, some people don't, but you can't please everybody. You should know that, so...
And what are you going to sing for us today, checkout?
From Escort 7?
Yeah. Let's go! Come on, Manchester! Let's raise the roof! Come on, it's X Factor! 2009! We're here! Dare to the roof! On your feet! Come on, let's go! Let's go!
When the world leaves you feeling blue, you can count on me, I will be there for you. When it seems all your hopes and dreams are a million miles away, I will be there for you. I've got you and
he's smiling.
I'm smiling.
Guys, it was like two drunks at a wedding.
I would say you were like two drunks who were thrown out of a wedding.
Absolutely no.
That'd be a no from me, guys. Sorry. No.
No, guys, it's four no's, but nice to meet you.
I have a belated birthday card for Cheryl anyway,
thank
so...
Thank you.
Oh, well,
thank
you. Well, give her a big birthday kiss. Come on.
Thank you.
Come on, big birthday kiss.
Thank you.
Big kiss.
Very much.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you.
Nice kiss.
Yeah,
did it.
Thank you
very
much.
See you
guys.
Thanks very much. Checked
out, as I say.
You did get a kiss from Cheryl.
Well, this is true, yes. Amazing.
It was wet. Wet. My face is wet.
So poor Checkout didn't make it through to boot camp. But that's not important right now. What is important is that Louis Walsh, in bed, wears pyjamas.
Yes, I wear pyjamas!
Anyway, we're getting distracted again. It's important to remember that people are here to audition, like Manuel.
My name is Manuel, and I'm a Spanish waiter. I'm not from Fawlty Towers.
Waiter!
Hello, miss.
How do you order?
From time to time, I can be maybe a little bit like Manuel.
Can I get a croissant?
A sandwich croissant? Me no nothing the croissant, me from Barcelona.
Sometimes I catch myself in a moment and I acting like Manuel.
Oh, and a sausage on the side.
And a sausage on the side.
Okay, that's good.
Any sausage?
Just a sausage.
I got a few of his mannerisms.
Sorry, so... What is this?
Que? Me no nothing.
That's a croissant, that's not a pan of chocolate.
Me no from Barcelona.
And also, I really didn't want it all served together on one plate.
No. In the future, I would like to be more famous than Manuel from Fawlty Towers.
He's the manager here.
Mr. Fawlty! Mr. Fawlty!
Hello.
My name is Manuel. I'm originally from Spain, and I've been living 5 years here in the UK.
Manuel, what brought you over to England in the first place?
I was tired of being a waiter. I was tired to serve everybody, you know, and the same joke, Manuel, Fawlty Towers, this and that, you know. I've been there. Yeah, you can laugh, but it's true anyway. I just decided to go for entertaining.
And Manuel, how old are you?
38.
38, great.
I'm 38, yeah.
Okay.
See the storm set in your eyes. See the thumb twist in your side. And I wait for you. Slide of hand and twist of fate. On a bed of nails she makes me wait. And I wait without you. With or without you.
So you
can do better than that, and I know I can do it better.
Hey, Manuel, we like you.
Ah, yes. Yes.
Danny, yes or no?
Yes.
Louis?
No.
Thank you. Is she a yes or no?
Carol?
Give me one, Gosh. I want to leave you down, Sam. I want to leave you
down. Well, but I don't think anyone's going to try harder. You got three yeses. Nice, guys.
Así Manuel say, ole, ole, ole. Muy bien, Manuel. Ole!
Manuel through to boot camp, but that's not important right now. What is important is that Louis Walsh in bed wears pajamas.
Yes, I wear pajamas.
Shh. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for Judge Moment of the Week.
Yes, I wear pajamas.
That was Judge Moment of the Week. Still to come.
I'm here for the limericks.
I just don't think you have the full package.
Nice one,
you're watching The Extra Factor. Now, do you want to go backstage? Well, you might not have a backstage pass, but don't worry, you've got one of me. Watch this. Hi, guys.
Hello. How can we help you?
Can I come in?
No.
I've been told you can't come in, Holly.
Yeah? You need to step back.
Really?
Sorry.
You're not coming in.
Oh, well,
guys, do you think?
Well, hang on a minute. Where are you going? You need me? And after some initial misunderstandings with security, I managed to sweet talk my way in and chat to the judges.
Have you had any terrible excuses why people can't sing?
Always.
Always. It's always a sore throat, isn't it?
The lips start to slowly stick to the gum.
Oh, it's horrible. Isn't
and
it?
You can see literally the saliva just disappearing.
It's my throat, it's dried up.
It's dry now, Simon. All you need to do is...
My voice is basically dry.
We should have a squirter.
A big water
soap. Someone whose job it is just to squirt water into people's mouths.
I can do that job.
You want to be a squirter?
I can do that. Well, look, I'm going to go.
She's going to clean my teeth.
Happy cleaning your teeth.
And one man who knows all about nerves is Steve.
My name's Steve, I'm 50 years old, and I'm from Staffordshire.
Hello, Steve.
Hello there, Holly.
How are you? You
all
right?
Very good, thank you.
Good.
I've never actually sung it before, and so this is the first time for me in, you know, to such a large audience.
So you've gone through your whole life without performing to anybody?
Nobody. Not even singing in the shower. I just can't believe how nervous I can get, but I'm determined to see it through to the bitter end. I've been always too embarrassed to sing. In fact, always too embarrassed to go on TV, so...
And then here you are doing both.
What I'm doing here, I don't know.
Well, Steve, let's just hope you can make an impression on our judges.
What's your name?
My name's Steve.
Hello, Steve.
And I'm 50.
What's your normal job?
I see what I love here. Do you see what I love here? Well, I'm currently unemployed.
Can we calm this down a bit, please? Everyone's getting very overexcited. Steve, where do you see yourself in 5 years' time?
Look, I see myself selling music, selling records, and making all sorts of new music.
What are you going to sing?
The first song is It's My Party.
Sorry. Okay, good luck.
Simon doesn't know where he's going.
Have you seen his trousers?
I was walking beside the sea when a beautiful angel noticed me. Hello, she said, with the warmest smile.
And it wasn't just the judges who didn't know where to look. Backstage, Dermot was finding it all a bit awkward with Steve's daughters.
I'm going to sound a really awful question. Is that his real name?
I don't know what's happening.
So,
freaking me out on the camera. The cameras keep going down.
Oh no!
Do I know you are a pie? With a loving feeling deep inside.
Well, Steve, I can tell you were having a good time up there, weren't you?
Yes, very much so.
Cheryl? Eyes up. What did you get to know about Steve there?
Louis?
Cheryl?
Steve, I just don't think you have the full package.
Nice one, Louis.
Yes or no? Louis?
Not for this show, Steve, no.
Cheryl, do you want to see more of Steve?
No, thanks.
Okay, it's a no, Steve, but thanks a lot.
Thanks, Steve.
Thank you very much. Anyway.
Oh, my God. You didn't see it.
So, sadly, it was a no for Steve, and he headed home.
Hi, I'm Louis Walsh, and you are watching The Extra Factor on ITV.
Louis?
Yeah?
What are you doing?
I'm helping you. I'm talking more of the show. Because Louis Limerick is doing so well, Holly, I thought I would help you a little bit on your show.
Louis, I give you one item and now you're linking into my show.
I'm helping you.
What are you doing? Give you an inch or take a mile.
I'm helping you. Everybody loves Louis Limerick. They like us talking.
Louis, they do. But listen, get back to ITV One now. Go and behave yourself. Go on. Go. Go.
Are you serious?
I'm cancelling Louis Limericks if you don't go in 5 seconds.
The people love us.
4, 3, 2, 1, go. Jacob it.
Manchester, I smell a limerick. Hello, I'm here for the limericks.
Oh yeah, that'd be £5, please.
No, I'm Louis from Louis Limericks. Hello, Manchester! There is a beauty in vogue who goes by the name of Minogue. Her hair's being restyled, and now she looks wild, but you still couldn't call her a rogue. Thank you, Manchester! You've been amazing!
It's been a day where some have taken one step closer to fulfilling their dreams. Whilst for others, dreams have been broken. But that's not important right now, because what is important is that Louis Walsh, in bed, wears pyjamas.
Yes, I wear pyjamas!
Next week... Yeah, man.
Nice bit of odd step.
Chicks in it.
Step believe.
Stay with ITV2 for Louis taking pals Boyzone to Edinburgh for a night out with Yvette Fielding, which could only involve ghost hunting. After that, in case you've just arrived home, there's another chance to see tonight's X Factor at 11:15.